Hello everyone. Welcome back to my channel. Today I am reviewing a very, very good book, and that is a poetry book by Haryette Mullen, that is Recyclopedia. One thing I have to note before I get into this is that this cover is horrible. I really don't like it. It's just every time I look at it, I'm like trying to think about what's good about it, and I just can't. I just don't like it. I noted some little poems that I liked, so I might go into some of these that I enjoyed. Recyclopedia is by an author called Haryette Mullen. I don't really know much about, but this is basically three different poetry books in one, which is Trimming's this one, which I don't know how to pronounce, and Muse and Drudge. Muse and Drudge is my favourite, I'm just going to say it right out there. Muse and Drudge is absolutely amazing. One thing to note is that I didn't have any poems that I noted in Trimmings. I just didn't really like them that much. It was an interesting concept. So Trimmings is about clothing items, and then the second one is about grocery store items or aisles in supermarkets, I guess, and then the third one is just poetry, I guess. I'm not quite sure. I know the first two I had to read for university, and then the third I just read just to finish the book, and then ended up being amazing. I gave this book 4 out of 5 stars. I just want to say that right away, because the reason I didn't give it 5 stars was purely the first two books. The first book was okay, the second book was better than okay, and then the third book was just absolutely outstanding, so it kind of balanced out, because the third one was just so good that I just had to give it more than like 3 stars. So that's what made it up for me. As someone who writes poetry, poetry is often extremely hard, really, really hard to write, and it takes a long time, and the fact that there are 180 pages worth of poetry is absolutely outstanding. There's just so much poetry in here. So I'm going to review this part by part. The first one, which is Trimmings. Trimmings kind of felt a bit like a blur to me, in that nothing really stood out to me. I liked the concept, but I don't think many of the poems really stood out in a way that captured me. I noted down what I thought about some of the books underneath, what I thought about them and what kind of clothings I thought it was about, because that is something that I have to write about in university. So I like quite a lot of the poems in the first one, but none of them captured my attention enough to worth noting about it. But I did really enjoy reading it. There was nothing in it that like I hated, or there was no poetry that I thought this is terribly written. It just wasn't to my taste. And a thing that you have to know about poetry is that it's very subjective. People like poetry the way that they like music, and it's all very down to taste, which I think is, again, something that you have to take note of in literature. So if this is your favourite book, or if you love every single poem in this, do not hate me, because I'm sure you do love it, but it's just not a poetry book that is my favourite. Anyway, that rant aside, number two, so again, this one, I'm not quite sure. I did note a couple poems in here. I noted 2 down, so I'll just read out the first one. Aren't you glad you use petroleum? Don't wait to be told you explode. You're not fully here until you're over there. Never let them see what you eat. You might be taken for a zoo. Raise your hand if you're sure you're not. Yeah, I mean, it talks to itself, really. I just really love poetry that has either a hidden meaning or that's very whimsical. I like whimsical poetry. I like poetry that you have to really think hard about to understand fully, or poems that you could just rip apart. There's just like so many meanings underneath it. And the thing that I like quite a lot about that poem and the next poem that I'm about to say is that it's very short and there's so much in it. It's so dense, and I love that. The next one is, refreshing spearmint gums up the words, instant perm kit combs through the wreckage, bigger better sperm kit grins down family of 4, scratch and sniff your lucky number, you may already be a wiener. See, I liked this poem on its own, but the fact that the last sentence is you may already be a wiener just literally made me laugh so hard, and I don't know if that's supposed to be funny, but I found it extremely funny, because I'm a child. So yes, the second one was considerably better, and I really like it. It's just so original to use like food items or stuff from supermarkets as poetry, like you wouldn't think to do that, whereas clothing is, I think, something that can be used quite often, but you just don't think of food to do that. Number three, Muse and Drudge, which is my favourite, and you can tell it's my favourite because this is how many notes I've got on them, which is quite a lot. There is a line in the third part in Muse and Drudge that is my favourite line in this entire book, and I'm not quite sure if I'm going to be able to remember where it is because I didn't actually note it down. This line has just stuck in my head. Yes, it's this one on page 118, and the last line is just, it's snowing on the radio, which is just absolutely incredible to me. Like, that line is just amazing. Like, that makes me feel so many emotions. I just absolutely love that line. It's just absolutely incredible. It just blows my mind. Honestly, some poetry is just insane. This is a paragraph from page 100. Another funky Sunday, soul-sewn picnic, your heart beats me as I lie naked on the grass. You know, teachers at school, we used to read out, I mean, especially one of my lecturers does this, where she reads out a passage or a poem and then she just stares at the book before smiling and then looks up. She just goes... Anyway, there's something that Haryette Mullen does quite a lot in these, is that she jumbles words together. I find words that shouldn't necessarily go together or that wouldn't work together in any other circumstance than in poetry, and she does it so well that it just makes for such a great poem, and it just makes me so happy when I read that stuff. So I have decided on two poems that I'm going to read out. So this is 161. Rap attacks your tick, cold fusions licks, could make you sick, nobody's dying in this music. Womanish girl meets mannish boy, whose best buddy is a doggish puppy. He dictates so dicty, she sedate so sedity. The girl gets biggity when the boy go uppity. I'm down to St. James Infirmary, getting tested for HIV. The needle broke, the doctor choked, and told me I'm croak from TV. When I say nobody's dying, well, I lied like last night. I was lying with your mama, who was crying from all the babies born in Alabama. It's just... Oh my god! I literally don't have the time to analyse that poem. I don't have the time. But if I could, my god, I would analyse it for years. This is page 172. Precious cargo up crooked alleys, mules and drugs, blood on the lilies of the fields. Drive by lightning, let Mississippi rip, catch some sense if you get my drift. Watch out for the wrecking crew, they'll knock you into the dirt. Your attic will be in your basement and you'll know how it feels to be hurt. A planet struck by fragments of a shattered comet. Tell it after the break, save it for the next segment. And I just get so excited about poetry. So yeah, those are my two favourite poems of this, probably this entire book. Overall, this was a great book. Some of the poetry fell short, I think, and if they were to be published in magazines on their own, I just don't think they'd hold up as well. I think it comes together really nicely in their own sections with other poems surrounding them, so it's nice as a collection, but some of them just don't hold up as their own poem. Like, it's a nice companion piece, I think. Overall, again, I gave this book four out of five stars because I just kept reading, like, the poems in Muse and Drudge. Once I got to that part, I literally could not put this book down. I was just flipping through it like, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. Like, it just gave me so much joy to read this. It was just so incredible. I'm so excited. I'm so happy that my university has given me this, has basically made me read this, because I don't think I would have found it by myself, and I'm so happy I found it, because this is a poetry book that I will definitely carry with me for years, because I absolutely love poetry, and this is possibly my favourite poetry book I've read so far. So that is that for that book review. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in another video. Bye.
We are running so